So hello students, welcome to our today lesson. We'll be keeping safe at home. Make sure you stay at home because that's where we are safe, and together we shall overcome. So on today's lesson, I want us to focus on the continuation of chapter number 6, whereby you have been dealing with the equation and the arranging of the formula. But the subtopic of today will be concerning the factorizing. So there are some of the objectives that I want us to be able to focus on them. And by the end of the lesson, I want you to be able to, number one, factorize the algebraic expression by putting the like term together. So today, we'll focus on factorization, whereby during this factorization, you are going to be putting the like terms together. So the process of removing the brackets, it has a certain name. This name is known as the expansion. So the process of removing the bracket is known as the expansion, while the reverse process of inserting the bracket is known as the factorization. So the other day we were trying to expand, whereby we were expanding, meaning that we are removing the bracket. But today we are going to factorize, whereby we mean we are going to be introducing the bracket and the equation. So for example, in this case you say factorize 3n. So if I tell you to factorize 3n, plus what? Plus 3n. So in this case, you have to come and make sure that you are looking for the common factor. In this case is the what? In this case the common factor is 3. So this 3, move it outside, then you come and say m plus n. Insert that, we say 3 times n, you get your 3n. Then 3 times n, you get your 3n. So this is what we are calling factorization. This is what we are calling the factorization, meaning we are introducing the bracket. We are introducing the brackets. So introducing of the bracket is the one we are saying is what? Is the factorization. But removing them is the one we are calling what? We are calling the expansion. We are calling the expansion. So the common terms is 3. So we put outside 3 in the bracket here, as you have seen. And then that's what you are calling the factorization. So let's see the next example. So my next example there, B. See what you have in there on a question there. So you need to check on the case of the solution. So in the case of B, we have AR cubed plus AR to power 4. Then plus a at power 5. So if you try to see what is common here, that is still common here, and then common here. So the first thing that you realize is what? Is a. So I can factor it out, then introduce the bracket. I'm going to have my r cubed plus r to power 4 plus r to power 5. But again, you can see I have another common factor here. There's some letter which is common here, then common here again, and common there. So if I remove the first R, I'm going to have the AR, then the other were 3, so they remain 2, the other were 4, they remain 3, and then they remain 4. So as you continue, you can see there is a common one here again. This is here, and also here. This is the R. So here this R1, so remove the second one, it's going to be R squared. Remain with R, now R to power 2, and R to power 3. Then finally, there is an R here, here, and then there. So this one is what? AR to power 3. Then into bracket, we have R1 plus R squared. That is the process that you're going to be seeing. So when I tell you to factorize, you have to be very careful to make sure that everything, the common factor, are removed outside the bracket. Because if you stop at this stage, you cannot be awarded the mark. Still, at this stage, no mark, and this term is no mark. So the mark is going to be when you come up to this stage. So we are insisting, again, if you come direct, maybe from here, direct up to there, no one can only be able to advise you. But we are saying in order to avoid the careless mistake, make sure that you go step by step, and then at the final, you can be able to be left with something which is not having a common factor. That is my solution there, you can be able to see. Working out, I'm able to see what you're talking about is my answer. Here to power 3, and then that is the final answer. That's where we move the, have the factorization as their final concept. So in this next example here, see, again I'm having concept there. This concept is where I've given you the answer there, but the C is supposed to be 4x squared y plus 20. X or 4, y squared, then minus 9, x cubed, y squared. So that's the question that you're trying to talk about. So starting from there, because you cannot go automatically the answer, you need to be able to find what is the common factor here. And if we start with the common factor, we are going to realize that on this case, we're going to have our first term. And our first term is going to be what? And see here we have an x. Here we also have an x there. And here we have an x. So in this scenario, so this is what? This must be that is x. So before we start with the x, you can see we have a 4 here. So if we remove the 4 outside, it's going to be left with x squared y plus. You turn it divided by 4, you get 5, x to the power 4. And then you have y squared, then 9 divided, that is divided by 4, we have minus 9. That's 2. So in this case, we continue again, you can be able to see our common factor is x again. Here you have x there, you have an x, and you have an x there. This one is going to be 4, x into bracket. We have our x, y now, plus here now we have 5, x cubed. Then we have y squared minus 9, x squared. Have x squared there, y squared. But can still, you can see, the, again, we are not yet through, because here there is an x. And here there is also an x, and an x there. So if we remove it again, it's going to be 4, x squared. Then into bracket, y. 5 x squared y squared then plus 9 x y squared. At this stage again you can see here we have an y and then here you have a y again and then a y. So moving outside then multiplying by this one is going to be 4 x squared y then into bracket 1 then plus it's going to be 5 x squared y then plus 9 x. So it's minus. We'll complete the sign. So up to this stage. That's what you're talking about there, factorization. So starting from the final from the first one, again we are coming here direct to this one as our answer. But you can see, for us to be able to come up to this answer, we are talking about what? We are talking you factorizing and being very careful with what you're doing. So we have to follow those steps, step one, step two, step three. All these steps assist you in avoiding the careless mistake. This one you avoid the careless mistake. Because if you see it direct, then you might be tempted to have some careless mistake. Then that one is going to cost you. So in my next slide, factorization by grouping. Factorization by grouping. And you're saying that when the terms of an expression which do not have a common factor are taken pairwise, a common factor can be found. This method is one we are calling the transition. So let us see, my next slide was going to entail on the factorization by grouping. So this is what you mean. And come to this concept. You have on this right that I'm telling you to factorize 3a. That is 3ab plus 2b, then plus 3ca. So this one will entail factorization by grouping. You can't factorize everything, but you have to group them into groups. You can pick this group here, and then you pick another group here. Then in each and every group, you try to find what is common. So coming to the group number one, you can see there is a common factor which is there. That factor is there. That common factor is what? That common factor is the B. In this case of the B, then we have 3A plus what? It's 2. Then again in my second bracket, you can see I'm having the C, the common factor, and that's what you're going to have from C. Then in this case, we have to continue then, so this case is going to be 3. Mm-hmm. That's what? That's 2. So the issue would be, what is inside the bracket is common. Have 3A plus 2, and then 3A plus 2. So you can be able to focus it into two groups. That is going to be 3A plus 2, and then we have B plus C. That is what we are calling in the case of the factorization by what? That's what you're calling the factorization by grouping in this concept. So I'm going to see what I'm talking about. 3a plus 2 is going to be your answer there. So this is what we are calling. It's very different from what we are doing in the other concept. So this is known as the factorization by grouping. So still another example on the KSM. It's going to be on my next slide, which will focus again on the concept of factorization by grouping. So check on my next slide.